I now request Dr. Vimla Patil to kindly deliver the keynote address.
Good evening, everybody. I'm basically a clinician. I've been working in the hospital all these years, so I'm not an expert to speak on this bringing equity into health policy, and many people have spoken about that. Before that, I just want to say this program started with a beautiful and energetic dance of roti dance on Ramzan Day, and I wish all of you I wish all these people of Ramzan wishes I want to convey, sir, and particularly our Khadar, sir, because it's my privilege and I feel very happy to wish him on this public forum. Before that, I made some notes on the issue. I'll just read out that. Please bear with me. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm extremely happy to be part of the inaugural function of this third edition of a national conference on bringing evidence into public health policy. I'm happy that such conference is being hosted in Karnataka, Bangalore, and is being organized in collaboration with the Health, Department of Health and Family Welfare, Government of Canada, Karnataka. Indeed, it is a matter of pride that the department has been a consistent partner for this forum since the inception in 2010. Karnataka stands ahead of national average on many important population health parameters in India. And indeed, the department has been working hard and initiating many new schemes to improve the state of healthcare services and quality of life people in the state. While some of the crucial health indicators such as infant mortality rate, maternal mortality rate, life expectancy are on rise at population level, there remains a disparity among groups within society. On some aspects of health, such disparities are not only stark but are indeed widening. It is impossible to attain health when seen in broadening meaning of well-being for all if we ignore glaring inequities. While we are committed to and putting in efforts to address inequities in healthcare deliveries, inequities in health status are not just emanating from healthcare, but reflect inequities in many other spheres of life, be it income, living conditions, social positions, etc. It is therefore very pertinent that this edition of APHP is focusing on the theme of health equity. I am particularly happy to note the concerted efforts are made to bring health practitioners and managers to such fora where they get opportunity to share their trade knowledge with health researchers. This is important for social and service delivery oriented sector services as healthcare. From Karnataka, we have deputed a good number of our colleagues from the department, and I'm sure we have representations from all the health practitioners and managers from other Indian states also. I look forward to fruitful deliberations and wish that we could come up with concrete ideas and new partnership in firmly move forward on the path of achieving first, just and equitable healthcare for all. Thank you.